Hello everyone and welcome to Learnaholic India. So today we are going to see top 10 machine learning algorithm for data science beginners. So in today's session we are going to see the types of machine learning algorithms, supervised learning algorithms, unsupervised learning algorithms and reinforcement learning algorithms. There are basically three types of machine learning algorithms. So let's start with the supervised learning algorithm. Supervised learning uses label training data to learn the mapping function that turns input variable X into the output variable Y. In other words, it solves for function F the following equation, that is Y is equals to F of X. This allows us to accurately generate outputs when given new inputs. There are three types of supervised learning: classification, regression and ensemble. Classification is used to predict the output or the outcome of a given sample when the output variable is in the form of the categories. A classification model might look at the input data and try to predict labels like sick or healthy. The next is regression. Regression is used to predict the output of the given sample when the output variable is in the form of real values. For example, a regression model might process input data to predict the amount of rainfall, the height of person, etc. Ensembling is another type of supervised learning. It means combining the prediction of multiple machine learning models that are individually weak to produce a more accurate prediction on a new sample. Now let's see unsupervised learning algorithms. Unsupervised learning models are used when we only have the input variable X and no corresponding output variables. They use unlabeled training data to model the underlying structure of the data. So there are three types of unsupervised learning: association, clustering and dimensionality reduction. Association is used to discover the probability of the co-occurrence of the items in the collection. It is extensively used in a market basket analysis. For example, an association model might be used to discover that if a customer purchased bread is 100% or 80% likely to also purchase the eggs. Next is clustering. Clustering is used to group samples such as objects within the same cluster are more similar to each other than the objects from another cluster. The last is dimensionality reduction. It is used to reduce the number of variables of a data set while ensuring that the important information is still conveyed. Dimensionality reduction can be done using feature extraction method and feature selection methods. Feature selection selects a subset of the original variables, where the feature extraction performs the data transformation from a high dimensional space to a low dimensional space. For example, PC algorithm is a feature extraction approach. The next algorithm is reinforcement learning algorithm. Reinforcement learning is a type of machine learning algorithm that allows an agent to decide the best next action based on its current state by learning behaviors that will maximize a reward. Reinforcement algorithms usually learn optimal actions through trial and error method. Imagine, for example, a video game in which the player needs to move a certain places at certain times to earn the points. A reinforcement algorithm playing that game would start by moving randomly, but over the time, through trial and error method, it would learn where and when it needed to move the in-game character to maximize its point total. Now let's see top 10 machine learning algorithm for beginners one by one. In this tutorial, I am only giving you a brief idea about each and every algorithm. So let's start with linear regression. In machine learning, we have a set of input variables X that are used to determine an output variable Y. A relationship exists between the input variable and the output variable. The goal of the machine learning is to quantify this relationship. The second algorithm is logistic regression. In linear regression, the predictions are continuous values. But in logistic regression, the predictions are discrete values after the applying a transformation function. Logistic regression is best suited for binary classification. In logistic regression, the output takes the form of the probabilities of the default classes. As it is the probability, the output lies in the range of 0 to 1. The main goal of the logistic regression is to use the training data to find the values of the coefficient B0 and B1 such that it will maximize the error between the predicted outcome and the actual outcome. These coefficients are estimated using the technique of maximum likelihood estimation. The next machine learning algorithm is classification and regression trees, that is CART. This is one of the implementation of decision tree. The non-terminal nodes of classification and regression trees are the root node and the internal node. The terminal nodes are the leaf node. Each non-terminal node represents a single output variable X and a splitting point on that variable. This leaf node represents the output variable Y. The model is used as follows to make the predictions. The next algorithm is naive bias. To calculate the probability that an event will occur, given that another event has already occurred, then we use the naive bias theorem. To calculate the probability of hypothesis X being true, given our prior knowledge, then we use the naive bias theorem. This algorithm is called as naive because it assumes that all the variables are independent of each other, which is a naive assumption to make in real world example. The next algorithm is KNN. The K nearest neighbor algorithm uses the entire data set as the training set rather than the splitting the data set into the training set or the test set. When an outcome is required for a new data instance, the KNN algorithm goes through the entire data set to find the K nearest instance to the new instance or the K number of instances most similar to the new record, and then the output, the mean of the outcome or the nodes for the classification problem. The value for K is user specified. So these five algorithms are comes under the supervised learning algorithms. Now we will see the unsupervised learning algorithms. A priori algorithm. The a priori algorithm is used in a transactional database to mine the frequent item sets and then generate association rule. It is popularly used in market basket analysis, where one checks for combinations of the product that frequently co-occur in the database. In general, we write the association rule for if a person purchases item X, then he purchases item Y as X relationship with Y or X follows Y. The next algorithm is K-means. K-means is an iterative algorithm that groups similar data into the cluster. It calculates the centroids of K cluster and assigns a data point to that clusters having least distance between its centroid and the data point. The next algorithm which comes under the unsupervised learning is principal component analysis, that is PCA. It is used to make data easy to explore and visualize by reducing the number of variables. This is done by capturing the maximum variance in the data into a new coordinate system with access called principal components. The next algorithm is bagging with random forest. In bagging with random forest, each tree is constructed using a random sample of the records and each split is constructed using a random sample of the predictors. The last algorithm is boosting with AdaBoost. AdaBoost stands for adaptive boosting. Bagging is a parallel ensemble because each model is built independently. On the other hand, boosting is a sequential ensemble where each model is built based on the corresponding the misclassification of the previous model. So in today's tutorial, we have covered some of the most important machine learning algorithms for data science. There are 5 supervised learning algorithms: linear regression, logistic regression, CART, naive-Bayes, and KNN. There are 3 unsupervised learning techniques: a priori algorithm, K-means, and PC algorithm. There are 2 ensembling techniques: bagging with a random forest and boosting with a ADA boost. In the next tutorial, we are going to see each and every algorithm in detail. So please comment below which algorithm you want to learn in detail. Remember one thing: sharing of knowledge is gaining of knowledge. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for latest video updates. If you like today's video, then like it, share it with your friends. Also, if you have any query, then please comment below. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.